The question is, well, will it be all that bad? I mean, warm winters, who can complain? Well, I got to show you this. So we know that we're coming out of this very highly advertised El Nino, strong El Nino season, and that has a major significant impact on global average temperatures, of course, increasing them, but that's not the only factor at play. Take a look, for instance, at this graph showing temperatures from 1950 through present day, and the orange bars, by the way, are El Nino. So obviously we're starting to see our temperature on the increase. That's well stated, well advertised. But El Nino, we're starting to outpace each previous El Nino years. Remember, this is a recurring cycle that takes place about every 5 to 7 years. So there's something else at play here. Heat trapping greenhouse gas emissions like carbon dioxide, for instance, and the angle of the sun. We'll get to that in just 1 second. But check this out. We even had to change the graph showing the 5 warmest years to show the trajectory of where 2016 is headed. February, the warmest February on record in 2016. And not only that, the warmest month on record. And we're starting to see a pattern here. So it's not only El Nino, we have other effects taking place. Look at that. Since May 2015, we have broken heat records across the planet every consecutive month in South America, in the United States, as well as the continent of Africa. Impressive stuff. Here in the United States alone, we had nearly 4,000 record highs. And, well, you're saying, well, what's the big deal? Why do we care? We have a warmer winter. Who's going to complain about that? Well, if you're ready for some heat, think what's coming in this summer. We have the change in the seasons that is about to take place. We're ending our winter season, transitioning into summer, where we're going to place the what was the low horizon sun right over top of us, allowing for that direct energy from the sun to help warm things up. So if the Center for Prediction, Climate Prediction Center is right on with their forecast, we have a very warm summer season. Even a warmer spring season in store, the New England coastline and the West Coast, where we know we have been in a well-advertised drought in California that only will have catastrophic problems for many parts across the world.